there's a big need in country Victoria especially to use a lot of resources that currently have no value, like waste heat. We can use that with new types of infrastructure. Infrastructure like is very common in Denmark, district energy. It's just pipes of hot water in the ground, in the streets, and you connect houses and factories with that district energy grid. You start exchanging and you create value for that waste heat that in Australia has no value. Funny wise, that will change very soon. And to enable communities to prosper again, we need to get that type of new infrastructure everywhere. We are now in Geelong. That's Victoria's second largest city. It's a city in transition and very industrial focused city has to transition into doing things a bit smarter. We're at the back there. We are seeing one of the few factories still left. That Shell oil refinery with a lot of waste heat, and that waste heat with my exchange initiative, we want to utilize that waste heat and pipe it to new developments. How to do that is not so special. You do that with plate heat exchangers, you do that with pre-insulated pipes, and you can just heat and cool the whole city of Greater Geelong with industrial waste heat, but also with newly renewable waste heat from power stations, from solar thermal farms, from a lot of sources. And behind me is the big location at Point Henry from Geelong. It's very visible from all around the bay. Alcoa is going to shut shop at the end of this year. They have been melting aluminium for a long time at that location. The location is perfectly situated with a deep seawater port to do more, and a waste to energy facility would be a fantastic follow-up of that aluminium smelting process, and with a possibility to revitalize Geelong.
I guess over time can create a lot of negativity in the community, given the fact that we've had quite a few catastrophes, pyramid, global financial crisis, and over the journey, you know, the whole industry landscape of Geelong changing. You know, we run on the sheep's back over many, many years. We had industries in grain, big industries in that. We've had Ford Motor Company, you know, we've had textiles industries all disappear off the face of the earth here in Geelong. And, you know, now we look at Alcoa, which is a crying shame. It's another big industry about to close its doors. So what for us in the future? And what is sustained energy, and what is a possibility for us going forward? Clearly, we talk about wasted energy, and how do we harness that? There's a way of doing it, a very real way of doing it. This may be the solution, this tiny little product here, nice pipes in and out, insulated, put through our streets, coming from industry, and saving us a lot of money. Who's not interested in saving money on wasted energy? And I can tell you, my friends, I'm interested. Are you?
In Denmark, in Holland, it's very common to have a district energy connection, and it's so reliable, it never has a failure. And the power has to come from multiple sources. You don't need to have a gas-fired power station to run electricity, or a brown coal-fired power station. You can have a biodiesel power station that I'm sitting on at the moment. We have solar thermal plants planned all around Australia, but nowhere they use the waste heat. They make electricity out of it, but you can use also the waste heat. And if you plan those solar thermal plants in new developments close to residential developments, you can use it. And the communities will prosper.